Mitchell Lawrence, a 17-year-old from Great Barrington, Massachusetts. He won't be graduating from high school with his friends this spring. He can't. He's in jail, serving a 2-year sentence for selling one joint's worth of marijuana, about a teaspoonful, to an undercover cop. He's never been arrested before, but he got 2 years in prison for one joint's worth of pot. Not community service, not a fine. 2 years. A cost to taxpayers of nearly $100,000, and a criminal record for life. How could this happen in America, when 100 million Americans have smoked marijuana? It takes two things, a bad law and a cruel prosecutor. Mitchell was busted in a drug-free school zone. But drug-free zone laws keep drugs out of our schools and protect our kids, right? Wrong. These laws do nothing to protect children. They just fill our prisons with young people like Mitchell Lawrence. 98% of people arrested in drug-free school zones weren't selling drugs to children. 95% of all sales aren't near any schools. And most of those arrested didn't even know they were in a so-called school zone, including Mitchell Lawrence. He didn't know that virtually the entire town of Great Barrington, like most American cities, is covered by giant drug-free zones. Mandatory prison for anyone arrested within 1,000 feet of a school. That's 3 football fields. It's a bad law that cruel prosecutors abuse, like fanatical district attorney David Capeless. He decided to press school zone charges on Mitchell Lawrence, a felony for a $20 sale. What happened to Mitchell is happening to young Americans all around the country. The only thing unusual about Mitchell is the color of his skin. 97% of all people arrested in drug-free zones aren't white. The time has come to reform these draconian laws and elect prosecutors who care about reason, compassion, and justice. We need your help to do it. Make our struggle your struggle. Stand with the Lawrence family by supporting a candlelight vigil on the courthouse steps. And join our fight to change these unjust laws. Become a member of the Drug Policy Alliance.